First of all, I'd like to say that I'm very deeply upset by the contents of the so-called report that has been maliciously circulated by an organization calling itself Environment Investigation Agency. I'm even more appalled that a Zambian newspaper can go all the way in defaming the president and his ministers without verification. I presume the News Diggers is supposed to be a professional publication whose core virtue must be to seek the truth, which is a value for all professional journalists. I do not want to believe that these journalists do not know their ethics. I believe they threw their ethics out of the window to please their sponsors, and this is very sad. We hear daily submissions from the media asking for press freedom. I'm personally an advocate of press freedom, but I do not support press freedom based on hating innocent Zambians. Ladies and gentlemen, government is under siege from its enemies, local and foreign. You are going to see more of this gutter journalism. You are going to see fake reports. You are going to see more malicious videos like the one you have seen today, provocative videos, and so on. These are all fake. Government will not be detracted by enemies of the state, local or international. As we pursue our development agenda, let me conclude by saying that I'm going, personally myself, speaking for myself, I'm going to sue the News Diggers. The person that has written this article is known, and she will receive some summon from myself. I thank you. I'll take questions. Yes.
Yes, Honorable. You've alluded to the fact that you see more fake stories than. My name is Stephen Wood from the Zambia Business. You've stated that we see more of fake stories generated by the enemies of the state. Are you in a position to give a hint to us which these enemies are?
Of course, they are known. They are known. These are opposition people who are, you know, opposition leaders. They are people that are wanting to get into state house by whatever means. So they are the ones that are behind all these things. We know they are using the media, they are using some of you to do these things. And it's unfortunate. It's unfortunate. We have the interest of the Zambian people to protect. The time for elections is not now. The time for election is 2021. And the people of Zambia will speak through the ballot box.
My name is Robert Smith. You said that you're going to sue the News Diggers. What are you going to do to the EIA? Are you going to take an action, or is the government considering taking any action against
you? Well, first of all, I would like to mention that we don't even know who these EIA are. So the News Diggers should be able to tell us who they are. And once we know who they are, they'll also be equally be part and parcel of the suing. You are coming from News Diggers, and I think you wrote your paper wrote that article, so you are supposed to give me those answers yourself. I can't answer that question. You have to give me the answers. The answers are within your newspaper.
Do you accept that Zambia is still struggling with the illegality of Mukula tree?
You know, as far as we are concerned, this Mukula tree illegality has been controlled. In the past, I'm sure all of you will bear me witness that you heard that there were 100 containers confiscated somewhere, 50 containers confiscated somewhere. From the time we restricted the harvesting and trading in Mukula, the numbers have been very minimal. The numbers have been extremely minimal. extremely minimal.
I don't know if I need to reintroduce myself. I'm Jimmy from CBC Television.
Yes.
There's been continued talk of the Forest Reserve 27, and according to certain information, the ministry says it did not allocate any of that land. I just wanted to find out how valid that information is.